I'm making shrimp and pineapple kebabs, and I'm making zucchini and red onion kebabs. Red onion, mushroom, and I think I'm gonna make like a little burrata salad. I honestly didn't even know what to cook because I didn't take anything out earlier. And I had to go to my niece's birthday party today, so I wasn't home. But this is just gonna be quick. My hubby's gonna barbecue. I'm putting a little soy sauce. I have some pineapple in here and like a little bit of the juice. I'm trying to use up like the older citrus that I have, so I'm gonna put some lemon juice. This is like such a random lemon. It's like so dry. What the hell is that? It's snowing. Oh my god, it hasn't snowed here at all, and I'm like actually sad about it because what is this? My kids, well, Serafina loves the snow. I bought all the kids snowsuits, and she's never even worn it. Okay, let's see. What am I doing? Let's put some orange. This is some of those. Look at these cute little mandarins I got from Trader Joe. No, I think that was just like an old lemon, honestly. It was very dry. It was like dry. It wasn't even hard. It was just dry. These things are so freaking cute. Thanks for sharing my live. That's so cool. Yeah, I completely agree. My kid deserves a snowstorm. And she didn't have off this past week. Like, I know kids in New York and some kids in Jersey had off. She didn't have off. So for the shrimp palm, my husband actually made the sauce. Shocking, right? A man that cooks. He just made like a quick marinara. And our marinara is literally onion, garlic, olive oil and good tomatoes and like fresh basil. What am I putting in this? I'm gonna put, let's just put some adobo for this. And then I'm gonna make vegetable kebabs too. Hi, how are you, Nazi? Hello from Sweden. That is so freaking cool. Hello. Thank you. I put some adobo, I put some pepper, I'm putting some Dijon mustard. If you weren't on before, I also put soy sauce, and I put a lemon, I put some like fresh orange juice, and a little bit of the pineapple juice. I'm making shrimp kebabs, shrimp and pineapple kebabs, and I'm also making zucchini kebabs. And then I'm gonna have like vegetables on the side, some sort of veg. I made my kids white rice too. I'm actually not, like, I have said to soak the kebab sticks, but I keep forgetting to do it. And shrimp cooks pretty quick, so we'll be fine. Thank you. Hi, guys. Are you guys cooking anything good? We were at a kid's birthday party today. My niece's birthday is tomorrow. And I was on the drive home. I'm like, let's just get takeout. But then I'm like, the price of food is like so crazy that for the amount of money I'm gonna pay for takeout, I'm gonna just go home and cook it for half the price. But also, if I'm gonna eat takeout, I prefer to go out to eat. Like, I hate getting takeout in my house because I'm still cleaning after it. You know what I mean? My opinion, if I'm gonna get takeout, I might as well just cook. Basically. I'm gonna let this marinate while I cut the vegetables and marinate those. Ooh, lasagna. That's good too, because you'll definitely have leftovers of that. Yeah. I know, my husband is like such a lucky guy. God forbid he comes home to a gourmet meal every night, right? Such a terrible wife I am. I'm gonna just slice these in like little wedges, I think, for the stick. I love to put zucchini with red onion on the grill. Most of my clothes, guys, this set, I actually bought from the pajama section. I kid you not. I'm gonna throw my hair off because I really don't want to get it in the food. I'm really hungry, guys. I like barely had any food today, and I'm hungry. And not even because I'm like starving myself. I just haven't had a chance to fucking eat. I have to throw it up in a high pony if you like have it straight, because then it doesn't stay straight. I have very curly hair. Oh, awesome. Did you make it with chicken, the other kebabs? Because you can really do that with anything. I've even done that with tofu. It's fine for me. Do I get hangry? Of course. Who doesn't get hangry? I definitely get hangry. Thanks, guys. Thank you. Thank you. So I'm just gonna cut these in like wedges. So I'll do like one here and one here. And then I kind of like peel them. So you can use like, you'll put them on like this. I actually posted a video on my nails like maybe yesterday or 2 days ago. This is Funny Money OPI. And this is like a marble that she just drew on. I'm making shrimp and pineapple kebabs, which I already marinated. I marinated the shrimp with some soy sauce. I put pineapple and some of the juice from the pineapple. I put fresh lemon juice, fresh orange juice. I'm gonna put a little olive oil in there as well, which I didn't do yet. What else did I put, guys? Whoever's in here, tell me. And now I am cutting down red onion and zucchini to make kebabs also, and my husband's gonna barbecue. I am Sicilian American. Started the St. Joseph pastry at the bakery. Oh my God. Tell me the name of your bakery again. Can you actually DM it to me? Because if you tell me in this live, I'm never gonna remember. So can you actually DM me the exact address of it and the exact name? Adobo and pepper, thank you. I didn't put any salt because the adobo is kind of salty. And shrimp is very delicate, so you gotta treat it like a delicate little babe, you know? I'm not crying, I promise. It's the freaking red onion. I'm literally tearing. Thank you, guys. I came home from that kid's party. My niece turns 2 tomorrow, crazy. And I just took my makeup off, and we were gonna get taken out, like I was saying before. But I was like, you know, which I have shrimp in the freezer, beautiful shrimps, colossal shrimps. I'm like, let's just make them. They defrost really quick. I like to just use the whole mushroom. I do take the stem off, but I do save the stem. I'll put them in like if I make like a meatloaf or something, or I'll even just freeze it for stock. I am gonna be making stock tomorrow because a lot of people are asking me what I do with like the leftover rotisserie chicken. I always boil down the bones and make bone broth, and I use it like wherever you would use stock in like a recipe, I use that. I fried the shrimp for the shrimp palm. So whatever I marinate, whatever I fry my chicken cutlets in, it's breadcrumb. It's equal parts breadcrumb and grated cheese, fresh parsley, garlic powder, onion powder, salt, pepper. And that's what I bread my chicken cutlets in, my pork cutlets, the shrimp for the shrimp parm, like whatever, anything I'm going to bread. Yeah, I'm crying because I chopped a red onion. The goddamn onions. I'm just taking the stems out and then I have to wash my hands. My things are like always gross and you can't wash them. I don't care what anyone says. I'll eat the dirt before I wash them. Oh, let me save these stems actually. Let me put them in a zippy. I use that breading for chicken cutlet too, yeah. Equal parts grated cheese, breadcrumb, garlic powder, onion powder, salt, pepper, fresh parsley. Did I say that? Definitely fresh parsley because it gets like crispy in the olive oil. It's real good. Well, whatever oil you fry in. When you're mad. Yeah, I did read that about rubbing them clean. But, you know, I read that, like, so many years after I was eating the dirt. So I'm just like, fuck it at this point. If you wash mushrooms, they get completely waterlogged. Mushrooms contain water like crazy. They're actually, like, little sponges. They get waterlogged very easily. Thank you, guys. I like just chill, like, lounge music. But I can't get into anything new. Maybe I'm just, like, not looking in the right places. But I just still listen to, like, old shit in my house. I wish I had a bell pepper. I'll tell you that. I wish I had a pepper. But I don't. Let me just check. No pepper, but that's okay. Okay, so the vegetables. My daughter's doing great with new foods, actually. So for the vegetables, I'm going to be doing olive oil and like a homemade balsamic vinaigrette. I have this sticky balsamic. It was really good. Like sometimes I'll just go to TJ Maxx and go to like their little kitchen section and they have like cool pickled items and oils and you know, vinegars. I bought this there. It was $5 and I've had it for a while because you don't use it on like everything. And it's actually really good. I would definitely purchase it again. I don't know the brand because it like doesn't tell you. But this is what it looks like if you wanted to just look for this. It's like a glaze, but a little bit looser. I enjoy it. So I'm putting a little bit of that. I'm putting olive oil. I'm looking for my salt, guys. No, I guess I should use this. I bought this and I like don't even really use it. This garlic salt chip. You know what it is? I just never know like how salty it is. Let me see. So this was like one of those compulsive Costco buys. And like I used it and then I don't know why it fell off it. Let's see. It's good actually. I like to control my salt, you know? So I have to taste it first. So I can gauge how much to put in. Thank you, guys. Okay, let me tell you, before I got started on TikTok, I was, like, trying to go viral on Instagram. But then I, like, because I didn't know how to use TikTok. Then I was like, you know, I'm going to teach myself. And I did. And at the end of 2022, I'm like, this is the year I'm going to go viral. Like, and I didn't even go viral for anything exciting. It was that stupid video of me and my daughter eating prosciutto and mozzarella. It wasn't even anything. Like, you scroll my page, I put these elaborate recipes up. Okay? Well, whatever. Whatever floats your boat, guys. Whatever floats your boat. I'm going to put some fresh citrus in here, too. To, like, tie it in with the shish kebabs, the shrimp. These are those mandarins from Trader Joe. And they're very juicy. Thank you, guys. This live is very positive tonight, and I'm totally here for that because I don't have time to block people. Honestly, I know everyone is entitled to their own opinion, and sometimes I block shit for, like, my own mental health. Like, if I read something and it makes me feel a certain type of way, no offense to you, but I block it. I block you. Because I can, you know? That's how I protect my space. Took me a long time to learn that, and I'm not gonna feel sorry for it, so. Sorry. Sometimes that, like, comes off as you being a bitch, when in reality, it's like, you're allowed to have an opinion about yourself. You're allowed to advocate for yourself. Exactly. I'm not gonna, listen, social media is, you know what you're getting yourself into when you're hopping on here. I mean, I do. It is what it is. I'm like very, thick skin, I guess you could say. There's a lot of shit that I just block and I don't even reply to, but some things I can't just block. Okay? Thank you. It took me like so long to stick up for myself. Like when I was younger, I know I say all the time, my mom worked a lot. She worked 3 jobs. So I was like a home alone a lot. And I hung out with the wrong people because my house was like the chill house. And honestly, like years later, me looking back, I'm like, half the shit that those people did to me, I would never stand for now, never. But you know, you live and you learn. But I'm not gonna bring that shit into my life now. I'm not gonna set that example for my kids. If that bothers you, that's a personal problem. Not my problem. That is delicious. You know what I'm going to do with this also? So I'm going to make the kebabs. And then I'm going to use the remainder of the marinade as the base of my salad dressing. That's me being a resourceful bitch. Okay? Sorry guys, really fucking annoying this cabinet. Is my cookie tray cabinet the only part that's like annoying? I can't fit anything in there. I'm gonna do the shrimp first because I don't like shrimp to sit in marinade, especially if it has acid in it. So I just cut the onion in half, right? So you have the half laying flat. I cut it like this and like that. So three, it comes in like 3 wedges. Let me do the shrimps first. See, when I'm on live, let me tell you what happens. When I'm on live, I don't clean up as I go. Because I'm used to, as I go, like, after I did my marinade, I would have put all that shit away before I went to the next. But, like, I'm trying to keep you guys entertained, okay? So then I have to clean up after, and it sucks. But it is what it is. So the shrimp, I'm just going to do probably like 3 per skewer. These are really huge skewers. It was all they had, but whatever. These are big shrimp. So I'm just gonna do, I like to like kind of put them very close together so they like cook on each other, like the juices like cook on each other. I have a lot of pineapple, so we're gonna double up on the pineapple. This was the can of pineapple that I opened for Serafina's lunch last week. Not last week, on Friday. And I just put a ton of fresh fruit, so this is never going to get used. So I'm like, let me just put it with the shrimp. I also put Dijon mustard in this marinade, guys. I don't think I said that. So this is what it's gonna look like. And honestly, I would also put scallions on here, like raw scallions. I would cut them like this and put them in between as well. I do have scallions, but I wanna use my red onions first. Yeah, my daughter Serafina is really sweet. And honestly, that shit that, like, there's no way I told my kid to say that stuff. She's just genuinely a nice kid. You know? And I'm just really proud of her for that. Auntie Amanda is cool. I don't really know much about, like, the whole TikTok shit, but I mean, I don't have anything against anybody. I think everybody is cool, you know? No one's ever done anything to me. Not my business. My husband's hanging out with his kids. He was doing science experiments with Serafina. I'll show you after I wash my hands. I have a tomaterranium sitting here in a salsa jar. I saved a salsa jar the other day, and I, my husband made a homemade terrarium with I don't even know if I'm saying it right, okay? But I'll show you it after I finish this. I'm almost done. They're in the basement hanging out. My basement is also a playroom. We were out all day. I had my niece's birthday party, so everyone's just in, like, complete chill mode. Mariella hasn't really napped. She napped in my arms at the party, but you guys know how that goes. This set is from Rainbow, and it was in the pajama section, actually. I mean, I don't wear it as pajamas. I wear it out. I'll put a pair of sneakers on it and wear it out. But it was sold in the pajama section, if we're keeping it real. Can I bake skewers? Sure. So how I would recommend you baking them is on a tray, like a cookie tray, but with a rack. So they're not sitting on the skewer. And I would cook them at a high temp. But I also would prefer if you did them in, like, a grill pan on the stove, if you have that. Because that might give you, like, the illusion of the grill. You know what I mean? I'm sorry to say, but I'm going to throw these pineapple out. I know, it's terrible, but I'm going to do it now. Again, I could have put them all in a skewer and just did a pineapple skewer, but hey, whatever. Thank you. My Mariella is a rainbow baby. My beautiful little babes. Serafina had no problem conceiving, and Mariella just, she's perfect the way she is. But I did have issues trying to have another kid. Thank you. Yes, I'm from Queens. I live in New Jersey now. So I grew up in Howard Beach, Queens. It's a little neighborhood in New York. And I moved to Staten Island for like 3 or 4 years. And we bought a house in New Jersey like 5 years ago. Like, I would love to just eat this raw. It looks so good. All right, I'm going to skewer these now. Thank you. Hi. So I like to put an onion, like, after it. Not everything, like, I'll do the, I did onion, mushroom, I'm gonna do zucchini, and I'll do onion again. That's what I'll do. Try to keep them even. I hear little Serafina feet coming up. Is that little Serafina feet I hear? You're on live, are you okay? You have clothes on, right? Okay, my fucking kids. Serafina's new thing is sports bras. My husband is not excited to enter this phase of parenthood. Let me tell you. So I like Newpok pizza. Are you kidding me? I love Newpok pizza. But you have to eat it there. We actually were talking about this the other day. You have to eat it there. You can't take it home. And that's your little veggie skewer. And my husband's going to grill them. I live in Central Jersey now. Like by the East Brunswick area. Thankfully you have two boys, seriously. You still gotta worry about stuff with boys too. It's scary. It's just scary in general being a parent, man. I'm supposed to put an onion now, guys. I'm messing up my pattern over here. You need equal flavor. I'm gonna just do two rows of this one because these are big mushrooms. Hi. A wellness tip is to drink as much water as your body weight is, half of that in ounces. So say you weigh 200 pounds, right? Drink 100 ounces a day of water. And I bet your skin and anything you got going on will feel a little better. Also, don't like stress about every single thing because stress is literally the number one killer. Yeah. Where you going, little tutu girl? Yeah, half of your body weight in ounces. He don't understand you like... Oh, Stop and Shop or ShopRite? Definitely ShopRite. But I guess it depends on where you live. Because sometimes, you know, maybe the shop right around you is better than the Stop and Shop. You never know. Skewers are very time-consuming, guys. Like, not really cooking them. They take quick to cook. Really more of just putting them together. The marinade on the veggies is a sticky balsamic, olive oil, salt, pepper, garlic, salt. What else did I put, guys? Who's here? What else did I put? What else did I put? I think that's it. Oh, I put some fresh orange juice. And I'm going to use this as the base of my marinade after I make my skewers, actually. I'm going to make like a really quick arugula salad. Yeah, like I said, it just depends on your area, I guess. I didn't have morning sickness with either of my kids. Luckily, I had very bad headaches with both of my kids. That's like what my biggest ailment was, but I never really got morning sickness. I used to just get such terrible headaches and that used to like make me sick. But it wasn't all the time. It was way more in the beginning. And it did fade. And now it's just a distant memory. Serafina is 5. Her birthday is in August. She's going to be 6. Mariella is 7 months on the 25th. So she just turned 7 months, Mariella. So I'm doing shrimp and pineapple kebabs on the side. I put these together already. I don't put the shrimp with the vegetables because the shrimp is gonna cook before the vegetables or, you know, vice versa. Like they're gonna need more, they're not gonna cook at the same time. And I don't like overcooked shrimp. So I do a veggie kebab and then I do a shrimp kebab on the side. I don't really know much about zodiac signs, but I would love to learn more if you want to share. Serafina is August. So what is that? What is her sign? And Mariella is July. My birthday is February 1st. Oh, Leo. Yeah, they're very like intuitive. Is that true? I think I did read about this actually. Love from South Africa. That's so freaking cool. Love from New Jersey. It's probably not as pretty as South Africa. Leo's and Cancers. Okay, now I have to do my research on them. I don't call her. If you want to, do whatever you want, cause you still won't give it up. My way. Love from Canada. Extremely confident, loud, true, talkative, true. and cancer, quiet and caring. That is so true, because Mariella is such a little sweetie. And Serafina is a little sweetie, too. She's the best. But Serafina has an opinion, you know? She has an opinion, and as she should. Here she comes now. I hear those dinosaur feet. There she is. My hands are dirty. What do you got for me, baby? Can you read it to me? All right, open it. Let's see the inside. Show me, baby.
You are lovely.
You made that for me?
You're a lovely bug. You're a lovely bug. You're a lovely bug. You're a lovely bug.
See, Serafina's a sweetie, too.
You're
my lovey bug, babe.
You're my lovey bug.
Guess what mommy's making for dinner?
What?
Shrimp.
Yay, my lovey bug. Yay, my lovey bug.
What are you guys doing down there, babe?
Uh-huh.
Is Mariella driving daddy crazy? Is he driving is he driving daddy loco moco?
No.
Crazy loco moco?
No. She's very nice. She
gets
that
kind of
she's hungry.
Okay.
Now
daddy got a bottle for her.
I got a bottle. I just need one.
All right, big sis. Love ya. I get my nails done at Blooming Nail Salon on Page Avenue. In Staten Island. I can't find a good nail salon here. And honestly, I still travel to my girl there. I was going to her before I moved here. And honestly, where I live in New Jersey is only like 15 minutes. It's right over the Outer Bridge. So it's fine. Hey, so it sucks I have to pay the toll. What part of Jersey you think we're close by? I'm in Central Jersey, like by the East Brunswick area. How did I pick my kids' names? Hi from United Kingdom. So cool. Hi from New Jersey. I picked my kids' names. I say this all the time. I grew up with someone named Serafina, and I just always loved her name, and she was just such a sweet girl, and I was like, I'm going to name my kid that, and I did. And then Mariella, my friend Chelsea, is friends with a Mariella, and I was like, you know, I really love that name, so I'm going to name my kid after your friend. I mean, obviously not after her, but she inspired. Mariella is inspired by her, and she is a very sweet girl as well, so I'm here for it. Hey, Amanda, how are you? They're dying for us to have a collab. They're all coming at me. Let me wash my hands. Maylin is so pretty. No, I'm definitely not having any more kids. My husband got a vasectomy. Like, literally, I gave birth, and he got a vasectomy, like, 3 weeks later. I don't even want a chance. I don't even want the chance of any more kids. I'm done with kids. I love my kids, but I can only handle 2 kids. I'm not a woman that is equipped to take care of more than 2. So this is that. My husband's going to barbecue this, but I'm going to make the salad dressing. Let's do it. I live in Jersey, but not far from Staten Island. I actually still get my nails done over there. My husband is from Staten Island. I'm from Queens. But my husband grew up in Annandale. And that Mexican restaurant you go to, La Iguana Azul, not only is their food delicious, but I used to get my eyebrows done over there. That used to be a little lady. It's like a spot that keeps changing. It's like a different spa every other week. It was a woman that used to be there, and she did amazing eyebrows. I used to go to her. So this is the marinade that I put on the vegetables, and the little bit of raw vegetable is fine with me. I'll eat that in my salad. Raw zucchini is actually very delicious, especially if it's sitting in like a marinade. So that doesn't, that doesn't bother me. But I'm gonna put some arugula, and I'm gonna just build a salad from this. Yeah, you wanna know why I like you, Amanda? Because you're like confident, and you just don't care, which I kind of feel like I'm the same way. I feel like when you are confident in the person that you are, it makes it easier for you to be like that. You know what I mean? Do I ever show my husband what? What am I showing him? What am I showing him? I'm from Howard Beach, but I do live in Jersey now, so. I haven't lived in Howard Beach in like 10 years. Yes, baby.
Can I have some balloons? Can I have rainbow balloons?
Where am I getting balloons?
I want some balloons.
Where am I getting balloons?
From the store.
You want me to go to the store and get you balloons? Right now? You're kidding, right?
No, I'm not kidding. If I was one balloon,
okay.
Blow it up and have a party.
Okay, well, not today. Different day. Different day, babe. We're not going to go to the store right now.
How about tomorrow?
We have school tomorrow.
After school.
How about after dance on Saturday? I told you I was going to take you to class. So I'll get you a balloon then. Should have been mine. This kid. Kids, it's pretty kids, man. I'm cutting up cucumber for the salad. Hey, okay, Aunt Justine said she'll bring you balloons next week. These freaking kids, they always want something from me. Babe, like 10 minutes, okay? You can actually put the grill on when you come out. How you doing, Mariella? You good? You chilling? You want some snacks? Want your ex? Here you go, baby. So bomb. Oh, you know I am Sicilian American. I get my hair done. Her name is Annette Does My Hair. You can look her up. She's on. I think she's on TikTok, but she has a bigger following on Instagram. I'm also gonna put burrata on here, but my phone is sitting on the burrata right now, so we'll just put it in last minute. Let me get a spoon to mix this. How do you pronounce my last name? So this, Leah's Cucina means Leah's Kitchen. That's not my last name. It's actually not my last name. I get my nails done at Blooming Nail Salon. It's on Page Avenue. Do I watch Jersey Housewives? I do watch it. I'm not up to date right now. I only saw like a little bit of the first episode of the new season. So I'm definitely not up to date. But this is what the salad looks like. A little salt. So good. Refreshing from the orange juice. It's like oniony from the marinade. Good. Hello from Texas. Hello from New Jersey. Who taught me how to cook? I mean, I grew up in the kitchen with my mother and my grandmother. They're old school Italian. They like getting takeout for us when I was younger was like a special occasion thing. You used to call me on my cell phone. Babe, you could go out whenever. I'm here. As soon as the kids start acting up, I'll hop off. Okay? Hi from Washington. So cool. Hi from Jersey. Thank you. Yeah, I know. I'm supposed to soak my sticks, but the problem is I decide to make skewers last minute. So here we are. But they're shrimp, so they're not going to go up because they're going to be on there quick. Hi. That's so crazy. This outfit is from Rainbow, but it's actually was in the pajama section. So I'm not ashamed to tell you that. I made a dressing with the leftover marinade from the vegetable. Ooh. So that's why. Yeah. This was the terrarium I was telling you about that he made with his kids. I don't even know what's in it. Maybe he put some sort of seeds. Who knows? I think they have an online shop, but I feel like the clothes on the website never look like what they look like in the store because I have looked at the website and I'm like, why do these look like terrible? And I mean, listen, in the store, you have to really weed through, like, some of the stuff is like a little too, not gonna wear it. Like the ones that look like Timberlands, but the heels, like some of the things I need to really weed through. I mean, I do buy like loungewear there, you know, because I go through shit so quick. My kids stain all my stuff. So I'm not spending money on anything right now. Like my furniture and stuff is nice, but I don't buy expensive shit. I'm not buying anything nice till my kids move out. Mariella's chilling. Mariella will vibe to anything. She loves music. Oh, both my kids, though. Right, baby girl? It's true. Some days I prefer to eat dinner like around now, but my, you know, the dinner's not done right now. We had a busy day. During the week, my husband, like if he's not home by 6, we'll eat by 6 because I have to still give the kids a bath and everything. But I really prefer to eat by 5 every night. Serafina is 5 and a half. I'll show you on a barbecue, right? That's enough.
Yeah.
I was looking for that.
We gotta work.
Is it good?
Yeah. Home is good when you make it, babe.
Go. You okay? Okay, Google. Volume 3. Me and my husband have been married, gonna be 6 years. We've been together for 11. We've been married for 6. It's gonna be 6 in July. We met online, actually. Plenty of Fish. A long time ago. I wanna be you when I grow up. I wanna be me when I grow up, too. You went to Stella with me? What's your last name? I know you probably don't want to say that on the live, actually. I would have to, like, click on your little photo. I can't really tell from the little photo. Thank you, guys. I am going to hop off soon, though, because I'm going to hang with the kids while my husband cooks. I know there's a ton of people on here, and I really love socializing with you guys. It's hard to, like, do it all, you know, but I like don't feel comfortable when I'm on live for long and like my kids are just chilling in the house without me. I don't know why. It's like a mom guilt thing. So thank you guys. Blooming Nails is the best. Yeah, I go to Nika and I go to Joey. I mean, they're all great, but those are just the two that I see. I've always saw Nika. I recently started seeing Joey too, like whoever's not busy. And I love Joey as well. She's such a sweetie and she does amazing nails. Maybe I'll try to do a mukbang later when we eat, but thank you guys for hanging with me. I will definitely show you what the dinner looks like. I will take a video and post it. Okay. It's on Page Avenue. You know where the drive-thru Starbucks is in Staten Island? It's right across the street. I love it. All right, guys. Thank you so much for hanging with me. You know, next time I have time, I'll hop on. I usually do a story before to, like, let people know. Enjoy dinner. Bye.